Somebody with a mobility disability like myself finds challenges in the simplest of things that everybody else doesn't even take into account. The promise and the hope for autonomous vehicles for many individuals is that I will be able to gain the independence that I really would like to have.
For the longest while, automated driverless technology was focused primarily on hardware and software, so having that level of autonomy. Needs of the user, particularly users that currently do not drive, were often being ignored. They did not consider the demand from people with different types of disabilities. And so that's where a lot of my research lies, is how do we bring all these pieces together?
D'Souza and his team are collecting data on users with varied physical disabilities. He's using this data to make design recommendations for autonomous shuttles.
Our main focus right now is on people that use wheelchairs. And what we do is our research team works with them one-on-one and give people the chance to actually go in and out of the vehicle, try out all the different features. Then we are also able to ask them very pointed questions about the experience and what features they would like to see in future iterations. So it also becomes a learning opportunity for us. Engineering needs to change. We need to be more inclusive in the way we actually practice engineering.